It's gonna catch all of the like, shading outside of it. So I did some lime work, and then I jumped onto the computer, and I had lime green, and like, let's say, like, this is the gecko. I like, wasn't looking, and I just went like this. And just the way I was like stretching, I thought like this was inside the gecko. So I just started like whip shading, like lime green. And then I pulled my hand away, and there was like this giant green whip shade mark. And the guy didn't see it though, so I was like, yo man, you know what looked real cool? I was like, this thing was sitting on some leaves. And he was like, yeah. I was like, I'm not gonna charge you, man. He's like, yeah, I'd love some leaves. So I just put a big leaf there.
Dan has a very distinct style that you know. Usually, when you see it, you can tell it's his own. You know, Dan's approach is just different, and it's unique. We're all special. Dan's just a little extra special, you know. He's into obviously tattooing, music,
the new Inquisition record. This is the shit right here.
He's into painting, and that's with brushes or aerosol. He's also into collecting and antiquing. Oh, he's extremely well-rounded.
It's confusing. It's a cultural identity issue. I'm almost, like, overly exposed to things. I have so many friends that are into so much interesting stuff, and I've managed to find merit in almost everything. Luckily, I've really kind of cultivated what I like the most about things that I like, and I've kind of made it work.
The shop I work at now is Smith Street Tattoo Parlor.
There's four of us working at Smith Street Tattoo. It's me, Kurt Crack, Eli Quinners, and Dan Santoro. Me, Eli, and Bert opened the place sort of together, and then Dan joined us about a year later. But Dan was always in the plan. Dan was like our fourth guy.
I was out of Dorms, and at the time that Smith Street was even a twinkle in any of their eyes, I was around a lot. I was spending a lot of time at Steve's. A lot of nights, get off work, hop on a train, go over to Steve's, have a couple of cold boys, some painting. So around that time, Steve had mentioned something that he was walking his dog in the neighborhood, and he saw the storefront that looked like it had been vacant for some time, and how he thought it was a really cool block right by the train, and you know, all this stuff like that. And he said, you know, he's going to look into it. I was scared to say yes at first. I didn't know Smith Street was going to be as amazing as it is. I mean, I should have known, but I didn't. And I thought about it for like a week, and then I was like, you know what? I'm just going to do it. I'm pretty impulsive and whatever, so I'm just going to do it. It's just one of those things where the planets aligned for Smith Street. We're all friends. Dream situation for me, working with these guys.
This is 100% our clubhouse.
I never feel like driving here from Queens like I'm going to work. I always feel like I'm coming here to hang out with my friends and have a good time, you know?
I think Eli's closer to Steve, and me and Bert, I think, might be a little similar. We exchanged birthday tattoos. We had the same birthday. So we actually did little cancer crabs on each other on one of our birthdays. Bert absolutely loves the fact that we're born on the same day. He brings it up about once a week.
I was born July 12th, 77. I believe he's July 12th, 83. I'm very much cancer, so is he, you know, hard on the outside, soft on the inside. We're both really sensitive, you know, like, it didn't take much to really ruffle our feathers, you know what I mean?
No, there's already graffiti, dude. Of course, but there's not already tags all over the fucking walls anymore. Alright, we're not having a fucking moral conversation right now. It's the dumbest shit ever.
Before Dan came on, I was kind of the loose cannon. Because I'm a little bit messy. I definitely can be a loudmouth. And maybe in a different way, Dan's now the loose cannon. He's just a pathological thinker, you know?
I don't know, it's like, you know, when we go to like Walmart and you see like the old lady with the puffy pink hat, sweatshirt. You know the feeling you get? That's how I feel sometimes when people bring like certain tattoos. Like, I really want to give it to them. I want to make it really good. Alright, so I get a phone call, and this woman's like, we have this woman, she wants to get tattooed. I think she got I think it was Charlie Brown, if I'm not mistaken. And she's going like, she's like shaking her leg. Within three lines, the tattoo was so fucked. So I was just like, it was like being on like a ride. I was just like, I did it, you know?
Nothing's ever set in stone with Santoro. Dan seems to be definitely the least organized out of everybody.
Dan also, you know, has the same mentality as far as that's our job of making tattoos, but Dan just does everything by the seat of his pants. And I think that the whole seat of the pants or unpreparedness or whatever, I think he subconsciously is that way on purpose. The way he tattoos, there's a lot of confidence, and even very simple, clunky tattoos just look so good.
He's one of my favorites for sure. It's traditional, real stripped down, real bare bones. I would say he's a little looser than maybe I am. I really try to do a very exact line and everything. And he recently moved me away from that. He's made me loosen up a lot. You know, I think he's kind of got a lot of what Dan Higgs had, and that he knows just how to put down a line and just do the tattoo, and it comes out how it looks great. They can make something look pretty and delicate and all those things, but they still have that Santoro look to them, you know?
Me and Dan, we do a lot of, like, really kind of bold tattooing, but it doesn't mean that Eli and Steve can't do the same thing. Well, we're a team, you know?
Almost every tattoo that gets done, good and bad, we show off to each other. I think that's a really good thing. I've worked in shops where I couldn't even tell you the last tattoo I saw of an artist for months, you know what I mean? Like, you just kind of work in your little corner of the shop, finish the tattoo, put a bandage on it, see you later. There's no fun in that. I mean, I want to see it. You know, I want to see what you're doing. I want to see if you did something that maybe I should have been thinking about. We bite the hell out of each other, but it's cool. We work together. That's why we're there.
These guys are just doing, the best set of tattoos around, in my opinion. It's the best job in the world. Yeah, by far. For the style, especially. We've been playing this trip for a while, from Melbourne, Australia. I don't know, we've saved up for 6-7 months or so, and then the tickets and things. We haven't done too much tourist stuff yet. We've just kind of been sitting in the shop. I think we're up to 11 now, and then got a couple more on Tuesday. So this one's from Steve, and from Dan. This one's from Dan as well, the little cat. The, I guess, girl from Dan's, crying emo heart from Dan as well. And that one's from Steve.
It just looks like a kind of special thing at Smith Street because we all do anything, but we all basically do the same thing too. People don't necessarily ask or say that looks like a Steve Bolts tattoo or a Burt Crack tattoo so much anymore as they might say that looks like a Smith Street tattoo. And I hear that and I love it. If you come to the shop and I'm not there, you're not afraid to sit in Dan's chair or Eli's chair because you know that you're going to get basically the same product.
Yeah, Steve and Dan. Dan right there.
We very consciously want our tattoos to look a certain way, and New York is part of that. New York's a very straightforward approach to living. There's no fucking around. And I think in tattooing, maybe there's a similar thing, whereas it's a very straightforward look to tattoos as opposed to it being fancier or, you know, more artistic. Hey, we want our tattoos to look classic. We don't want them to look dated, you know. And I know when somebody comes in and wants, like, an owl on their chest, it's like, why don't you just get a fucking eagle on your chest? Why do you gotta get an owl? Technical application is what will make a tattoo slick to me. You know, and it's a good thing to just be able to give somebody a nice, solid, clean, predictable tattoo. That's a good thing. And even if it's a tattoo that 50 people have, it's new and it's original because, you know, because you have to put your hand to it, you know?
You know, we're all really going for the tattoo style. We want our tattoos to look like tattoos. You know, like when you're a little kid and you think about what a tattoo is, the first thing for myself, and I think a lot of other people that popped into their head, you know, like the anchors, like Popeye had, or even a mom heart or something like that, like just something that would almost be represented in a cartoon, so to speak, you know, like what you picture in your head when somebody says the word tattoo is usually some sort of tattoo imagery, not, you know, some no outline color portrait thing, you know what I mean? So I mean, I think that's probably unifying in that terms, you know, we use a bold outline, a lot of black shading. You know, we have a lot of the same reference material. Tattooing is an art, and its form is, you know, this traditional, almost sailor-style tattooing, you know?
I guess maybe I started tattooing late enough. There was still, like, enough going on with people wanting to do traditional stuff that I was like, okay, I know I want my tattoos to look like that, but how? And then I was like finding the Dan Higgs tattoos that were in Tattoo Times. Tattoo Times is a publication that Ed Hardy put out from early 80s probably to like the early 90s that had the weirdo art section. And they're just really strange tattoos, but they still had that traditional application that I was looking for in anything, really. I mean, I just, you know, I'd see tattoos and not really know why I liked them, but I knew I just liked them. And then I'd realize down the road, like, oh, it's because they're bold and, you know, they're simple.